So number of ply, which is I, is equals to I minimum, which is equals to 4. So therefore use 4 plies for the belt of 28 OZ fabric grade having 800 mm width. Below is the note regarding I minimum and I max. What we need to consider: if I minimum, I is less than I minimum and which is less than I max, then at that time I is equals to I max. If I is greater than I max, then change belt fabric and select higher strength belt fabric. Okay, because in this case I, if it is greater than I max, then you have to check for higher strength belt fabric. Now we have to finalize the thickness of the belt. Thickness of the belt is given by the formula: first bracket ply thickness into number of plies plus top cover thickness plus bottom cover thickness. I have explained to you in figure of traction element. Upper part is called as a top cover thickness, which is denoted by T of T, and bottom cover thickness is called as T of B, and ply thickness is in center. Now we will be assuming all those values. Ply thickness is equals to 2 mm, top cover thickness equals to 3 mm, and bottom cover thickness equals to 2 mm. Putting all this value, you get T equals to 13 mm. Step number 5, selection of standard motor. We know the formula for motor capacity, which is equals to P into V actual upon efficiency. Now we know the power, that is 8319.4. we have found out V actual is 2.75 for 800 mm width belt. Efficiency we are going to assume as 85%, so we are writing it as 0.85. so we get the motor power as 26 kW. Now therefore, selecting standard 3-phase induction motor of capacity 26 kW with 1440 rpm. Step number 5, that is design of pulley. We know this is again a relation. Diameter of pulley is given by D equals to I. I is nothing but number of plies, K1 into K2. K1 and K2 are factors. I is equal to number of plies equal to 4. We have found out K1 is a factor based on belt material, which is in the range 1.25 to 1.6, which we have assumed, which give you the value of 1.43, that is the average of this range. K2 is a factor which depends on percent utilization of max tension and arc of contact. So again, K2 is a factor, so the value for it is 100, for arc of contact 180 degree, and the utilization is 100%. Now putting the value of K1 and K2 and I, you get the diameter of pulley. So diameter of pulley is equals to 572 mm. Pulley width is denoted by B1, and this B is nothing but the belt. Pulley width B1 equals to B plus 2 into margin. Margin we will be considering as 50. We know the belt width as 800, so we get the pulley width as 900 mm. Next step is step number 7, design of pulley shaft. This is a cross section of the shaft. In the center, you can see at the extreme, we can consider the pulley shaft. Now the material for the shaft is C45. For that, shear stress tau can be considered as 40 Newton per mm square. Now you will get a clear idea. The length of the shaft becomes 1000 mm. The load acts, that is a load on the shaft at the center. So the load on the shaft can be calculated as T1 plus T2. We know the value of the tension. After putting the value of T1 and T2, you get the load on the shaft as 22278.18 newton. Now the next is bending moment on the shaft. You know that bending moment is denoted by MB, which is equals to load on the shaft divided by 2 into the total span divided by 2. After putting the value, you get the bending moment. This is the value for the bending moment. 5.57 into 10 raised to 6 Newton mm. Now we have to check for the torque on the shaft. Torque on the shaft MT, which is given. Now the torque on shaft MT equals to T1 minus T2 into D by 2. D is the pulley diameter. We know the tension T1 and T2. Just simply putting the value and the diameter of the pulley, you get the torque on the shaft. Now the next term is equivalent torque. Equivalent torque is given by under root of bending moment as well as torque on the shaft. So you'll just put the value, you get the equivalent torque. You know that equivalent torque is equals to pi by 16 into ds cube into tau. Tau is the shear stress, ds will get, after putting equivalent torque, you will get the value of ds, that is the diameter of the shaft, which is equals to 91.77 mm, or which is equivalent to 92 mm. The next step is selection of bearing. So the load acting on the bearing will be T1 plus T2 upon 2, that is a tension. We note the value of the tension, just simply putting value T1 and T2 divided by 2, you will get the load acting on the bearing. So it is somewhat 114 kg force. Actual load FA will be equal to 0. We know that the bearing speed, how to calculate that? V actual equals to pi dn upon 60 meter per second. You will get n, because we know that the V actual is 2.75, 60, pi you know, d know the diameter of pulley. You will be getting the n, which is 91.34 rpm. Now the S, expected life for application of conveyor plant for the bearing is 800 to 12,000 hours. This we get from PSG page number 4.5. So the life in hours of the average 8,000 to 12,000 hours is 10,000 hours. So life in million revolution you get by the putting into formula LH into 60 into N, that is the speed of the bearing, divided by 10 raised to 6. So you will be getting the life in million revolution by putting all the values, you will get 54.8. Now equivalent load on bearing is given by the formula P equals to in bracket XVFR plus Y into FA bracket close S. Here X equals to 1, V equals to 12 for outer 1.2 for outer ring rotation, S equals to 1.3 for heavy shocks, and the actual load is 0. After putting all these value, you will be getting the equivalent load on bearing. So the value is 1737.84 kg force. Next, we will be finding dynamic capacity, which is life in million revolutions raised to 1 by K into equivalent load. We know that LMR 54.8, K considering over here is 3, 1 by 3 into equivalent load, which is the value, you get 6600.9 kg force. So from PSG page number 4.14, we select the bearing as 6219, the grade, and having C equals to 8500 kg force and T equals to, that is the diameter, equals to 95 mm. So the dynamic capacity is 8500 kg force and the diameter is 95 mm. The next step is design of idler. So we know the relation for the design of idler. We know in terms of belt width, Li plus twice in bracket Li minus 50, which is given by Alexandrov. Width we know that it's 800. Simply putting all this value, you'll get Li. Li is nothing but length of trolling idler, which is equals to 300 mm. So we can finalize with size of idler is 5125 into 300 mm. Now as length of the belt, LB is given as twice into L plus pi D. Twice, you know the L is 100 plus pi, D is the diameter of pulley. We'll put the value, you get 201.79. Now number of throwing idlers are required, which is equals to length upon spacing. So L and throwing idler spacing should be 1.5. L you know 100 spacing is 1.5, you get somewhat about number of towing idlers which you are required is 66.67, which is equivalent to 67. So the total number of towing idlers 67 into 3, which you get 201. Number of straight idlers, again you know the length L is 100, spacing is 3, which is equals to 33.33, say suppose 34. So the size of the return idler is 5125 into 900 mm. Now this 900, how you got is, you know, the 800 as a belt width plus 50 on both the side will give you the 900 mm. So this is return idler.